What's up, everybody? Welcome to episode 3 of the Labyrinth Lifers.
Fucking right.
Just quick recap on episode 2 if you weren't with us. In episode 1, we met in the, what town was it? What town did we meet him?
Shadowdale?
Shadowdale.
There you go.
We all found a flyer. We were hunting this lost girl for a reward. Fog came in, came out. We're in this strange swamp. Fought a couple of monsters. Oh, fought an alligator that clomped on to Yarrowin. And then 3 frogs came up on us. These were some vicious, vicious frogs. In the process, Janstina about fried half the group. We had 2 people unconscious. It was a rough, rough scene. We recovered from that. We found a chest. Where's the chest now? Is it just kind of sitting around the campfire?
Yeah, until the thief is ready to work on it.
Okay. And
I think y'all are letting the thief recuperate.
Right. So we're resting, trying to get our strength back because we're totally exhausted. And that's where we're at?
Yeah. That's where we're at. We're the next morning after everybody resting. Everybody's back up at their hit points. Everybody should pick their spells for the day.
I got cure wounds twice.
I guess I'll stick with what I have since I don't know otherwise.
So I know 2 spells and I have 2 spell slots, so I can have one of each then, right?
Correct.
And then
yes.
My 4 cantrips?
Yes.
Okay, that's what I'm doing then.
Good. Before we get started, Corey.
Yes.
You have a dream in your sort of altered state while you're recuperating about the merchant that gave you the drink.
Nice.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Okay. You see him, and he's trying to offer to give you more.
Oh.
And before you can go to take it, you wake up.
Okay.
Some heavy shit right there.
And then that's how you wake up. And you're back to normal now, but you are, you're halfway disoriented. Sorry.
You gotta talk again. It sounded like a chair fell over.
I know.
It's still Dirk, so still.
There we go.
Blaine. He's not completely normal, though. He is missing hair.
What do you mean?
And blistered.
He should be a little crispy.
He is. But Corey, this is what's important. You saw somebody that you haven't seen in eons that basically changed your life with that. He said, and he says his name in the dream. He said, Denovan will return.
Denovan will return?
Yes. Now, when you wake up, you're a little disoriented from everything that happened. You're not even as quick to anger as you should be because you're a little out of it. But once you come to it, you look at Jeff and you want to kill him.
Just seen it.
Once you sort of, like, gather yourself. Now, you're a little weak to do it, but, yeah, Janstina, you want to kill her.
Yeah.
I can sell you a Toyota.
But you don't have the strength to do it. So, you're biding your time. You're hoping maybe the dwarf will listen to you, and you guys can decide what you want to do. But that's where we're at. Denovan, who gave you that concoction, said he will see you again.
All right.
Okay. So this is the beginning of a brand new day. The weather has not changed. It is awful outside. There is no rain, but it's constantly bubbling in the clouds.
Bubbling?
Yeah, it's the
still the swamp.
Yes, the clouds just keep boiling over. They seem like they're about to pop, and nothing's happening. You're not getting any rain, but it's constantly overcast. And thunder and lightning.
And we're on an island, correct?
We're in the middle of water. Yeah.
No. You got to an island, right, and you set up camp. And
how big is this island?
It's small, but it looks like it could extend into larger territory.
Is there any animal paths or anything? Like goat paths?
It's swampland, so everything is very unclear. I mean, you can... there's a lot of overhanging trees, moss. You actually don't know, like, what's solid land and what's not. You know,
are they mature trees or small ones? Or?
It's cypress.
Okay, that makes sense.
All cypress all around, and there's moss. And,
like Spanish moss?
Yes.
So
Ravenloft moss. Yeah.
I want to look for the biggest, sturdiest cypress tree around, like,
okay,
area.
Deja
vu. I want to scale.
Okay. Everybody else is looking at the halfling, looking for trees. Does everybody just let her do that?
What about the chest?
You still got the chest.
Yeah, let's open the chest.
Merlin can go look for trees.
Yeah, we'll check the chest while Merlin's out checking the trees.
It's going to have to be solid, I believe, right?
Yes, he's the rogue.
Yep.
Yeah.
Solid, let's pop this baby
over. Solid, let's do this.
Solid. You want to do a lockpick?
Absolutely.
Okay.
And I just want to tell Aramel and Than, and I'm super sorry about setting you guys on fire.
I don't want to hear it.
Yeah. you just killed me, basically. I'm lucky to be alive.
You're alive. You weren't dead. You were just sleeping.
Yeah. Okay.
He's lucky to be alive.
So, my expertise on...
Dexterity.
I do have thieves' tools. Thieves' tools. And I also selected check. One...
Go ahead.
I also selected was one of my expertise points as my thieves' tools, which is supposed to double my proficiency bonus.
Okay. Nice. Dexterity check with proficiency bonus, if proficient with thieves' tools.
Right, and then my expertise also doubles my proficiency bonus.
What's the expertise in?
Thieves' tools and... Thieves' tools and deception.
So you can double your proficiency in thieves' tools with...
Yeah, wow. If you look like a rogue or expertise, I can select two. Can either pick two of the skills, or I can pick these tools and one skill.
Okay. Roll a 20. You're trying to pick the box, right?
Yeah.
Dear God.
Well,
really? Thank God for the +8, I guess.
All right, you pop it open.
Nice. What's in there?
Dead flies.
Yeah, there's two hands, like human hands, chopped off. Yeah.
Hands.
So inside, you find waterlogged food, clothes. Gross. And two short swords wrapped in soaking wet cloth.
What type of clothes?
Wet ones.
I mean, it's like a tunic.
Okay. Is there any like embroidery on the edges that would indicate like a noble type of tunic, or is it more of homespun, rough, and peasant-like?
It looks like something a soldier would wear.
Okay.
Tunic-wise. But the swords are in excellent condition.
They're short swords, you say?
Yes, two short swords.
Okay. So, who else would wield a sword besides Sainan in our group here?
Me. Me.
Because I have a nice
long short swords.
Yeah, so I determined that, you know, I don't need him. If you want them, you can have them.
I can't use them. So I say give them to the thief.
Agreed, everyone?
Yeah.
Who's it going to?
Stalid.
It's going to Stalid.
Alright.
So what is it? What do we hear around there? Do you hear any animals? Just bugs?
All
right, so once we get through with this, while we're waiting on Dirk, what's our next course of action here? Is Marla up a tree?
I've wandered off to climb up a tree. I have no idea what's going on.
He doesn't.
And yeah, I've not been paying attention. Just so y'all know.
Okay.
You know, before he gets back, Pete, with those swords.
I've been trying to whisper to him to try and use them, but.
Well, we need to probably see if they have any magical properties. We'll probably have to do like find someone to do identify spell on it to see what it is.
Yep.
Terrifying magic.
Magic.
I don't have detect magic prepared right now, so okay. I'd have to wait a day, but I can cast it. I just don't have it prepared.
Okay, y'all start in the morning off. Still the shitty weather. You've got a lot of swampland ahead of you, even though it's a little more solid land. Yeah. Not as much moss, trees.
Did Merla find a tree?
Did Merla find a tree?
Yeah, she was looking for a tree to climb up. A nice tall one for a cypress.
Yeah, you found a cypress tree.
Alright.
Also in the forest of cypress. I hope he found a cypress tree.
What are you doing with the cypress tree?
I want to survey the terrain, see what's out there.
Okay.
She's a climber.
I would have said don't ask questions you don't want the answers to.
Merla, as you're in the trees, you notice smoke far off in the distance.
In what direction?
Yeah.
North.
North?
Yeah.
Off the edge of the map?
Yes.
So my north or your north?
Your mom's north. Merlo's north. He's the one that sees it.
Are you gonna share that information with the rest of us?
I don't know. I climb back down the tree and I eat some rations that I have stored.
I'll be honest. With all the secrecy and like division in this group and like attacking a raft. I don't see you guys like making it, you know. Y'all gotta pull your shit together. Pull your shit together like big time.
Alright, let's all gather around, hold hands, and sing Kumbaya.
No. Just get that fucking halfling in line. And then you're good.
Well, we don't know any better right now. Let's get a move on. Let's head out.
So I finish eating and I start heading north.
Bye.
Myrtle, where are you going?
See ya.
Bye, Felicia.
We lost you.
Are we
you
with
10
Myrtle?
Feet away, but you're so short. You're like buried in the reeds.
What do you think? Do we follow Moon?
Listen, I said we follow, but like stay 20 feet back and let them and let her take the first hit.
You see Merla start taking off towards the north. She doesn't say anything to anybody. She just starts walking.
She's ranging. We might as well follow her.
Merla, where are you going?
I'm going north.
What's north?
Are you sure that's north?
What color smoke?
Smoke-colored smoke?
Is it black? Is it gray? Is it white?
I don't know.
It's white. It's white smoke.
Oh, thank God.
Sorry.
That's a good sign. If it's white smoke, that means it's a settlement of some sort.
Maybe like a house fire or something?
Yeah. Not a house fire.
It's not
a house
on fire, but
a hearth.
Right.
House fire.
Let's head that way.
It's Palomera. Since off.
Can you tell about how far away the smoke was there, Merla?
I was just some distance off.
It's about a day's away.
Oh. So before we get too far, I'm going to go up and grab that tunic that was in the chest since no one else claimed it.
Okay. I'll grab the hand.
Is that before or after my whisper?
Oh, wait, the dog.
What whisper?
Let me see.
Kind of defeats the whisper.
Right.
Well, no,
exactly.
I just wanted to. I was going to do it until the GM had, like, internet problems.
I'm taking the hands.
I'll trade you some information for those hands.
All right. They're all yours.
Why don't you just give him a thumb? Nail that shit out.
Time begins to blur for everyone as the dull, sunless days merge into black, moonless nights. And even though each night bubbles and boils with energy, there is no sound of thunder and no rain falls. Twilight is nigh. In the distance, you see a light. Do you draw near to investigate?
What kind of light?
It looks like something that's sort of on the horizon.
How far on the horizon?
About 50 yards.
Still in a swamp?
Yes. But it looks like a small, dry patch of land.
I would absolutely want to go in that direction.
Yeah.
Where the smoke was coming from.
Is it like a trail leading up to it, or is it
no trail?
Just trees and grass.
All these questions. He just walks towards the light to see what's up.
Who does?
Thanen.
Thanen
okay.
does. Yeah. Okay. I skulk behind a tree.
Okay.
I'm gonna hunker down.
I'm going with Thanen.
Okay.
We're burn buddies.
Yeah.
So, I would really like to get my feet dry and get off out of the swamp. So, I'm going to just start walking in that direction. Either if there's a path, I want to walk off the path and in some sort of stealthy manner.
Yeah, I'm going to hang back and be stealthy, but I'm going to follow you guys out.
There's no path, but a small dry patch of land rises out of the still stagnant water. The light comes from a fire that forms the center of what appears to be a small camp. In the solemn flickering light of the fire, you make out a bright and multicolored gypsy wagon. Two old mares, three brightly clad children, and an old crone. A moment later, two men step into view. One is old and thin, with long silvery hair and an apparent bad eye, while the other man is young, dark, handsome, and fit. Setting themselves by the fire, the old man slowly looks up in your direction, his good eye now upon you. The other eye, you notice, is milky and blank. He smiles and motions to you with his withered hand, seemingly inviting you to his group.
Greetings, gentlemen.
I'm a backup.
You're not very charismatic, are you?
I am.
Yeah, I'm just going to stay back behind a tree right on the outskirts of the...
I've got picks.
I'm going to hang back while Thanen greets these guys.
I'm hanging back.
So my perception is pretty beefed up. Can I, like, do a perception roll, or, like, whose turn is it, or...
No, anyone can do anything. If you want to see if you perceive anything, just say it.
Yeah, okay.
And Thanen's walking up and introducing himself.
Well, Thanen's an idiot.
I'm going to hang back, and I want to use my skills of perception.
These guys could easily be as nice as the goofballs in this group.
Right.
I'm looking for a new group at this point.
I would exercise caution, Thanen. I know you're not going to take my word for it, but...
Let's see. How do I send a pick?
Well, Amy said she wants to do a perception check, so she should roll a 20.
Go for it.
Yeah, and I'm hanging about 120 feet back.
Roll the
20. Amy got critical perception.
How'd you get a +5? Holy bucket!
If you're proficient in perception. You have a +3 from your wisdom and +2 for the proficiency.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He smiles in motion to you with his withered hand, seemingly inviting you to his group. What do you guys do?
Damon's the only one who does that.
There's a wagon.
And I rolled that perception check, so I want to know what happened to that. I was maxed at 25.
Perception check?
Yeah, 25.
What's it for?
I just want to perceive whether this guy is genuine or not, what he's got up his sleeve, if not.
Yes.
Yes.
He seems genuine.
He seems. I want to perceive deeper. I think my perception skills can look past anything that he might want to throw at me. I want to go under that and see what the truth
is. He seems genuine.
Is he genuine?
Yeah.
All right, I'm hanging about 120 feet back.
Dude, you're still back on the island if you're that far away. You're in the water.
The only thing that's odd about this whole situation, you know, there's kids playing, there's old people. They seem harmless. They're gypsies.
Do they have to eat?
Do they have anything to eat? I imagine so.
Anything on that fire.
The odd thing is that they have a wagon out here in the middle of nowhere.
The swamp.
Well, they're gypsies.
Yeah.
So Thanen greeted him.
Yeah, I introduced myself. What happened? Gentlemen. My name's Thanen. Where the heck am I? What is going on?
We're way down here. Be up here.
Okay. So
we've been stuck in the swamp for days.
There's the old blind man is old Skaringi. And then there's his wife, Rihanna, who is
a Chris Brown?
A plump woman with silver hair and laughing eyes. They have a son named Carloni, who's a strong young man with black hair and a matching mustache. Father to the three children. He drives the horses. He's eager to put as much distance between his family and a house called Marais de Terrasson. Valana, the daughter, is a gorgeous, enchanting young woman with dark eyes and bright red lips. You guys approach in a friendly manner, so Skaringi, the old man, responds in kind. Although the son remains distant and makes no effort to hide his desire to resume their journey. Skaringi says, there's a village of Marais de Terrasson at the edge of this swamp. It is not far, but is not a place to visit on a night such as this. Better to stay in swamp, I say.
Could you maybe point us towards Shadowdale?
What is this Shadowdale you speak of?
The town.
I call out from the trees, where are we?
You are in Sarogni.
Where the hell is Sarogni at?
Sarogni is a state within Ravenloft.
What's Ravenloft?
Oh, my friend. He looks down at the ground and doesn't know what to say to you. I fear that you are here from another land. If that's the case, I fear that you will never see your home again.
What do you mean? From another land? I'm approaching at this point. Coming up next to Thanen.
Alright. People that usually come here from other lands never return.
This land has
an ability to trap people here.
Not trapping things.
You mean we did some sort of planar shift or planar travel or something?
This land.
So we were
here already. What do you mean? So we didn't travel anywhere.
His wife interrupts and says, she shushes all of y'all and says, to speak of evil is to invite it to dinner. These forces here in Sarogni, they hear.
Okay, so at this point, I'm going to approach and introduce myself and ask if I might join them at the fire.
Absolutely. You're welcome to our food and drink. You seem like good people. I heartily welcome you into our family.
This Jan chick is not to be trusted.
Why not?
But
he got serious.
She recently killed me and one of my teammates, or knocked us out. And we haven't traveled with her for very long.
That is really your responsibility. If we have to take care of her, we will.
I'm going to jump in and just kind of try and smooth things out here. I'm pretty charismatic and awesome. I think we're all good. Thank you for your hospitality.
So, wait a second, you're vouching for Jan?
Yeah, I'm vouching for Jan.
Did you see what she just did to us?
It was an honest mistake. Got a little crazy with the cone and...
An honest mistake. We were directly in front of you.
Look, and I'm you pretty shut perceptive, and I think she's telling the truth.
Okay. The old man comes back in, and he shuts that all down. He says, gosh. I'm inviting you to dinner. You can share the fire till morning. Perhaps, he says with a sparkle in his eye, there will even be time for a fortune.
Can I ask?
Merla, go.
did Jan pick up the tunic out of the chest?
I did. I said I did.
Hey, okay. So you think you might want to ask this guy if he recognizes it from anywhere around here?
I was gonna let Merla talk first.
That's all right.
She's been trying to get in a word a while. But that did cross my mind, Pete.
Yep. By the way, I'm doing this on the, I'm not asking him in front of the old man. I'm asking just
on the side.
Me to you.
Okay.
Do I still have the hands?
No, you gave him the Merlin.
No, I have the hands.
Yeah.
Well, you never gave me any secrets.
You never asked me for any information. You said yes, so you still have that in your pocket, the bit of information.
Okay.
Well, I'm eating.
So I want to approach the wife and take some food and ask her what this evil is that she speaks.
Do we have any ale to go with this?
What's the old guy's name again? Because I want to ask him about that tunic that I picked up.
And I want to get and does the old lady answer me about the evils as I eat their food and hope to not get poisoned?
Just don't give them the ham.
What are we asking him?
She said not to speak of evils lest we invite them upon us, and I want to know what evils that she's referring to.
He wants her to speak about the evils.
And we shouldn't call them gypsies. I believe they prefer Roma.
This isn't Eastern Europe. This is Ravenloft.
They get everywhere. You know how those gypsies are.
Evils, it's not a specific term. This land is filled with evil. I speak of evil in general. To speak of evil is to invite it to dinner.
So can we, like, kill it and eat it?
You will not kill this evil.
Whoa.
Okay.
So you guys eat at this point?
Yeah, what about the tunic?
Y'all want to eat with these people?
What about the tunic? I'm already eating. I've been eating this
whole
time.
Already said thank you and invited myself.
Okay.
I'm eating. What about the tunic? Did I miss something?
Who's asking who about the tunic?
I'm asking the old guy about the tunic.
I've never seen that in my life.
How about these hands?
Yes.
What hands?
I the hands that I pull out of my hands.
Out of my hands.
They looked at you as if you were insane and looked at your party and said, "Who is this?"
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not used to civilized company.
This is Marilla.
This is not civilized here. You are crazy.
That may be true, but that doesn't answer my question.
We found these hands in a chest.
Under a boat.
We don't know really what to think of her yet. She hasn't done anything to make us lose her trust, but we did find these hands in a chest. It's
your best bet,
not that weird.
Your best bet in this land is to bury those hands immediately.
Okay.
I take out a string.
If I hear this, I say, what? Let's listen to him and bury dead body parts.
I think we should bury him too.
Yeah, I think we should bury him.
After dinner, Valana emerges from the back of the wagon with a noticeably, noticeably decorative patch. It's the first time you guys see her.
What's the patch look like?
It's a pouch.
A pouch.
Yeah. Decorative pouch. The oaken door at the rear of the wagon opens, revealing
a door.
Yeah. Well, a door. Yeah, in a wagon. Absolutely.
Hobbit door. Okay.
Like revealing a
revealing a curvaceous young woman with dark, penetrating eyes. She smiles a bit slyly. Casts her eyes downwards before anyone can snag her attention, then settles near the fire. This is my lovely daughter, my little Vapici. Her name is Valana. There is no other. He laughs and she appears embarrassed, flushed. Mouth agape at her shyness, he retreats and continues. Valana will be telling you your fortune. As adventurers, you'd be lucky to accept this gift. Not many get so much of an opportunity, yes? Valana turns to gaze at each of you, one by one, with a flicker of firelight twisting in the middle of her vacuous black eyes. The trouble began when I cast the runes for that quiet and lost young man, she says, trailing off sadly, turning away. Perhaps it will end with another casting. She grabs a flat pan and places it in her lap while holding on to a group of stone tiles. After gazing once again into everyone's eyes, she drops the tiles into the pan. Immediate shock and a trembling lip. A long pause, and then the lost one is called you, she gasped. Each member of the surrounding family hastily makes some sort of protective gesture. The dead will walk with the coming storm. This I tell you in truth. And you must find a way to walk them to their final rest. For if you cannot, she pauses again, her lip once again quivering. The rain of Saragni will turn to blood. It will drown you. You and all of Marais the Tarasson. At this point, her eyes were nearly orange with fire and fear. Mm. Panicked, the old man Sarangi quickly ushers his wife and daughter into the wagon. No charge for the fortune, sir, the old man added hastily, stuttering. It is time to rest after these adventures of the day. If you would be so kind to forget this overreaction, please. We mean no harm of you and yours. Be our guest. Give us a chance to calm these fiery spirits and rest in the midst of a solid warming fire. And they retreat.
Into the wagon.
Well, I think this is probably a safer place to camp because you said it was about a day's travel we did from the island to here.
Yeah.
And it's another day's travel to the town.
Yeah.
Well,
everybody went inside the wagon except for Karlani, the son, who is at the driver's seat of the wagon with a heavy cloak around him, but he's closing his eyes as if to sleep. So, it's nighttime. I don't know if y'all want to set up.
Well, we should set up around our giant campfire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Agreed.
Yeah, I'm a little suspicious because I think they're afraid of us at this point, so I don't want anything to happen to us. But I know that I can't be put to sleep by magic, and I have the advantage on saving throws against being charmed. So I don't know if that puts me in the place to not have to worry as much about anything they might try and pull.
Like a knife?
Not like a knife. That's not my jurisdiction.
I'd be more worried about them dipping in the middle of the night while we're sleeping. I think we should set up a watch of some sort, just to.
But I'll take watch with that thief. I don't trust him.
Interesting.
What'd I do to you?
I don't know. I'm just saying.
Okay.
All right. So do you want to pair up? Because I'll pair up with Jan. I trust her.
That's fine.
If we want to do.
You're the only person that does.
I'll pair up with.
Yeah.
I think we should double up. I mean 2 hours. 2 hour rotation. That's like 6 hours.
Okay. As you guys are setting up for camp, Corey.
Yes.
You notice that you see Valana's figure outlined in the wagon doorway. Roll a 20.
Uh-oh.
All right. Come on, let's get lucky.
What's your wisdom?
You're going to get lucky.
What's your wisdom?
You're gonna get unlucky.
Wisdom is
7. And what's your modifier?
Ugh, my wisdom is -9. What, -1?
Okay. Roll 20.
How'd you become a sorcerer?
Right, that's what I'm wondering too.
I'm just not very wise.
He's a new one.
Yeah, very intelligent. I'm just not very wise.
He's only
book smart.
He's only book smart. He doesn't have trail smart.
Yeah, no street smart.
Wait, do I need... Oh, no.
Ooh.
Oh.
That's a three.
You're not getting that, Dave.
Well, plus... Well, yeah, plus, minus one makes it a three.
Yeah, three.
Okay,
You're going to become a goat.
Jan Steen, a roll of 20.
All right.
Damn it.
What are we rolling against? Is this against wisdom?
Wisdom.
Oops. My bad.
Six?
No, I didn't roll a six. There.
Damn.
What's up?
What'd you get?
I got a 19.
Oh, okay. So, you see her figure outlined in the wagon doorway.
Jan or?
Valana.
No, okay. Aramil or Jan?
Yeah.
So Jan does.
Okay.
She speaks barely above a whisper. But you can hear her clearly. She says, "Beware the madman. Beware his blood." She whispers forcefully. The door is closed and she's gone.
Interesting. You guys missed that. Do you guys see that?
They didn't see it. You have to relate it to them.
What
happened? Is there any around here?
The one daughter just was standing in a doorway, and she whispered to me, "Beware the madman, beware his blood."
Beware his blood?
Yeah.
Really?
I don't know what that means.
The general populace?
I fear no blood.
Well, good night.
Sleep tight.
Okay. So,
all right. What
are
you
camp
thinking?
Time? Okay, no. You set up your patrols for the night.
So it was me and Merla first, right?
Yeah.
We'll
take the last watch. Me and Yarwin.
Okay. Are y'all ready for the patrol?
Yeah.
Yeah.
First patrol falls asleep immediately. Everybody else sleeps through the night. Oh. Copy.
The two people on watch just fell asleep immediately.
So everybody slept through the
saving
night.
Throw
all,
on that.
All six of us.
Right.
Correct. Dirk.
What's
that?
All six of us slept through the night, like babies.
Yes. Nobody woke up.
Oh.
I'm sending you a picture of the Vistani. You were just seeing.
Myrtle better check to see if his hands are still there. Her hands are still there.
All four of them.
Or did you bury them?
Thought we agreed to bury them.
Well,
Merla didn't agree.
No, I didn't agree. My hands, I kept them.
So we made it through the night sleeping, or did something happen?
You made it through the night.
Okay, is the wagon still there?
When you wake up, it
when
is
I wake
gone.
Up, I'm pissed. So
why weren't we woke up?
We just wake up naturally.
Yeah, you wake up in the morning and the cab, the wagon is gone.
Whoa.
So let me get this straight. The halfling and the tall woman
and the rogue
burnt me to shreds. Oh, it's the rogue.
Of course.
Rogue.
Okay. Was not me. Okay. Was right. not me. All right. I was sleeping.
So what happened?
We're all sleeping.
You're supposed to wake us up for the second shift. What happened?
What's up?
No idea. They must have done something because...
Gypsy magic.
We immediately fell asleep.
My father should have taken the first shift.
It's crazy.
I call bullshit.
And are we sure this wasn't a spell that Jenstina threw?
No. I don't have sleep magic.
I can't be certain of that at all.
I don't have sleep magic.
She didn't charm me if that was the case, because I would have known.
The raft remains where you left it, but there are no trace of the Vistani family.
Oh. Wait, how the hell did the raft get here?
Yeah.
For
a day's travel from the coast.
Oh, never mind. Then the raft.
We left. Oh, thank God, because you really would have freaked me out.
Okay, so I'm scrambling to look through my kit here.
I want to make sure nothing was taken.
What?
Right.
Do I have everything still?
Next day.
So we head to that town they spoke of?
Yes, you're headed on in that direction to that town.
Is there a path? Or
no, but they give you a direction to head in.
Wait, did we check our belongings? Last I knew, we were waking up.
Did you set your spells for the day?
I have Cure Wounds twice.
Okay.
So I got my same set. Right,
yeah, I'm working on the same. One of each.
Yep, same.
Okay. So, on the fourth day, you discover a house in the distance, in the swamp. The trees in this part of the swamp encircle the raft, forming a thick entanglement of branches and bare, gnarled roots.
Raft.
What raft?
We're on foot.
We're not back on the raft, are we?
We didn't go back to the raft.
Well, you're not going to be able to get across the water without a raft.
Oh,
so we're leaving the island?
We left the island.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, we did a day's walk.
A walk doesn't leave an island.
I know, but...
You guys didn't bring the raft with you?
We didn't cart it across... Carry it for a day?
Carry the raft.
No.
Left that sucker. It was on piece of shit on fire anyways, yeah, thanks to this Jan.
Well.
How do you adjust the volume of the music in the background? Because I'm having a real time.
To the gear. It'll be my setting. And then.
Found it.
Under. There you go.
Thank you.
So we should have brought the raft.
Yeah, but it's fine. So since you don't have the raft, y'all are like waist deep in water. The trees in this part of the swamp form a thick entanglement of branches and bare, gnarled roots, making what little progress here slower and more difficult. Sharp, fractured limbs scratch your arms and legs as you push the raft, as you push forward. And the persistent wind sings a lifeless melody as it rushes through the leaves overhead. As you break through a clump of thorny foliage, a light appears in the distance, brighter than a single lantern, warm and inviting in the cold, damp air. The light is not at eye level, hovering in the dark. You've got to look up to see it properly. Hmm. An inexplicable natural attraction, like moths and flames. You seem to slide towards the source of the light. It is a decrepit wooden house, hardly larger than a shack. Light spills forth from its two front windows and a wide open door. But most noticeably odd is the fact that the house appears to be suspended in the air, above the swamp surface.
Is it on chicken leg?
Its reflection shimmering in the harshly dank pool before it. No chicken legs.
Alright. No fence of skulls and bones around it?
Mm-mm.
Alright.
Almost like one of those old kajian houses that are just like four sticks up.
Right.
Okay, this freaks me out. Nice people around a campfire, I'm cool with. Floating houses?
Floating.
No.
It's very intriguing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't
I'm gonna go in the house.
From the angle,
detect magic.
From the angle they have, you guys, you cannot see inside from the bottom.
Okay, so can, hey Merla, want me to boost you up and let you peek over the edge of the floor up there?
Okay, all right, but no funny stuff.
Yeah, I don't want any funny stuff either. I just want to know what the hell's going on around here.
All right. Real quick.
All right.
Count of three.
So three. If I boost him up, can she get her eyes above the floor level to see in?
Yes. The front of the shack has two windows and an open door. There are no windows or doors on the sides of the structure. The back wall only holds a single window, also bare. The house has no porch. There is no sign of a boat, and no curtains cover the windows.
Can't see in enough. Oh, sorry.
Marilla, can't no. see inside the house?
Yeah, that's what you got. Can you see
anything in the house? That's it.
Okay. That's what you got.
Climb in.
No.
You can't climb in without, it's too far up.
Oh, I'm too short. Somebody else go up in this creepy house.
Well, I was boosting her up.
Okay.
It looks like it's too far for you guys to get up there.
All right, okay. Dwarf, you're loud and brash. Mm. You think somebody should, yeah. Mr. Charisma?
I'm not Mr. Charisma.
Yeah.
I'm not down with this house. The magic side of this freaks me out.
Can you dwarf toss the halfling up there?
Dwarf toss.
I'm not getting dwarf tossed.
I'm gonna shoot an arrow into the door.
Okay. I would throw a rock.
I wouldn't even do that.
I'm gonna grab Corey's arm. Be like, arrow. Wow. Maybe you should think
twice. What's going on?
Right? Well, good call.
We can't reach it. What else are we supposed to do?
Well, let's see. Okay.
So how far above the surface is it floating?
I'd like to do a perception check again, I guess.
For what? My
spidey sense is tingling. I perceive magic because you know, it's floating.
How far up? The porch on top is about 10 feet up.
Okay.
So just the two tallest people. Boop, boop, boop. Have them, you know.
I'll climb up there.
Yeah, I'm 6 foot something.
Yeah, we're waist deep in water. So if you're 3 feet and then... Or how many feet? Doesn't sound like we're still missing.
I'll go up there if you need another person, if you think you can.
Okay.
Everybody. I'm pretty.
While you guys are debating this, suddenly a rope ladder drops down from the doorway.
I'll climb off the ladder.
Well, hold on a second. The ladder, constructed of wooden steps and thick rope, simply rolls out with a brief clatter. Knocking the wood. The last step hangs just above the surface of the fetid water, inviting all to climb up. No one invites you. It's just a ladder swaying above the black water of the swamp.
Okay, I'm going to shout out a friendly hello.
No response.
I say, well, yeah, Jan, if Jan's willing to do it, send her up there.
I'll
come. Yeah, I'll come next, but you're probably...
I gotta redeem myself somehow.
Yeah. You want to take any precautions?
I want to drop Jan and tell him, you know, maybe the healer shouldn't be the first one in. You take get taken out. Who's going to heal them?
Send dwarf up.
Okay.
I'll send a dwarf then.
Dwarf's not going.
I'm going to use my persuasive powers.
I just go. I look at
all right.
Somebody like,
Merla. Going.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. So while they're scrambling, Merla goes.
No, I'm head over. I'm fighting to get there before Merla.
Okay. Roll 2 20s between you. What'd you get, Amy?
I don't know.
What's your dex bonus?
Hold on. I'm just down the wrong.
Roll a 20 and add your dex
bonus. Okay, so I rolled a 7. Merla beat me.
Well, we don't know that. Okay. Roll a 20. You roll a 7. What's your dex bonus?
I think it's 2. That's my proficiency. I think my dex is 1.
5.
I got what's a 15. Your... Wait, what?
Got a 15.
You rolled a 5 and you got a 15?
No, I rolled a 10 plus 5.
Oh, I got you. So, okay. Merla wins. Merla is going up the ladder. Okay. Merla. The small house seemingly has one room. All told, more than 2 dozen lanterns hang from pegs on the wall, flooding the shack with maddening light. To the right of the door, unopened boxes adorn the wall, neatly stacked. An open-topped barrel rests beside the barrel. In the center of the room, facing the front door, is a young man. He sits within a circle of 5 burning lanterns, large unblinking eyes fixed in place with a vacuous stare. At first glance, he is unusually thin and pale. His long, whitish blonde hair hanging limply to his shoulders. His features reveal the soul of someone long tortured, whether mentally or physically, hard to discern. His simple shirt and pants appear crisp, clean, and fresh. In his lap is a small book, which he is clutching tightly. As he sees you pull up, he makes no move to greet or even acknowledge you. It's as if you aren't even there. But then, a phrase emerges from his lips, slowly and somewhat indistinguishable. Beyond the sin shall evil of night the land. At near is signs of hexad this when hand. He then returns to his quiet trance-like state, neither speaking nor responding in any way.
He said, what?
I peeked what? Down off the porch and then yelled down to everyone. It's like, there's some sickly looking kid who's speaking gibberish up here. I don't think he's much threat.
So I was right behind him. Could I hear him too? Or was he the only one in there?
Dirk.
What's that?
But I was right behind Merla. Could I hear the kid too? Or
yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Is it something that I might? I don't know if you languages.
No, you have no idea what he's saying.
Okay.
What's going on up there?
What is going on?
I just yelled down. There's the sickly pale kid.
Did you come up?
So So, you know, I do know abyssal, too. I mean, it doesn't sound like that. It just sounds garbled, but...
Try and talk to him.
Hey. Hey, pale dude. Why is your house floating?
It's a great question.
He looks at you and says nothing.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to talk to me. I'm going to sit down and have something to eat.
What, he's got some boxes up there? Open one.
Yes, he's got boxes.
And barrels.
And barrels. And a book. Kind of interested in the book.
But he's
is there room on this? I look over his shoulder and look at the book.
Is there room for all of us up on the up here?
Yes.
Okay.
Who's up?
And is there a porch that goes all the way around or just on the front?
All the way around.
How many exits?
But I want to walk around. I want to walk around the back.
There's only an entrance. No exit. Just an entrance. All
right. So I'm look. Okay. You want to look in the box? I want to look over his shoulder after that. Get a gander.
Who's looking in the box?
I'm climbing up. I'm looking in a box.
Who's looking in the boxes?
Merla, but very, very sneakily.
Well, you can't be very sneakily when there's five people up there and, you know.
Oh, then, you know, there's the chaos. It's distracting.
Well.
Merla, slyly.
Sure, Merla, sure. Okay. Who's the first person to check the boxes?
Really? I was.
Who called it first?
Who suggested
Corey did, but...
Corey did, yeah. He said there's boxes.
Corey did.
Check them. Yeah, I guess I'll check the fucking box.
Corey checked the boxes first. Corey?
What?
When you open the boxes, there's like a ton of fresh food. There's like chicken, freshly cooked chicken. There's rations. There's vegetables, a bottle of wine, lots of stuff.
Okay. I'm gonna close the box and tell everyone what was in it.
Okay.
Food. Let me at it.
Thaman, what else are y'all doing here?
Thaman's eating the food.
Search.
So, Bannon. I was trying to walk around the back side of it.
Stop, Bannon. See if
inspecting.
Wait. I'm hearing five different things. I need order.
Let's go with the box. Thaman heard me say there's food and is eating it.
Okay.
I'm absolutely eating it.
I'm not eating it.
Shouldn't you guys not eat that food? You should.
Right.
Make sure it's safe to eat.
It's delicious looking.
I want to use my perceptive skills here. Can I do a...
Okay, roll a 20.
Do I have to roll anything as I'm eating the food?
No, because you didn't opt that. You just started eating.
All right. I just mean...
And for me, I was walking the outside edge looking at...
The dwarves are want to do, to be honest.
I'm trying to walk the...
I rolled a 23 for a perception check.
Okay, perception for what?
Well, first of all, I just want the general perception of the scene, but I also want to know what's up with that food.
The food looks good.
It doesn't look enchanted or poisoned or...
I mean, you can't tell if it's poison. You know, you're not an assassin.
Doesn't have a glamour over it. Is it?
It looks legit to you. It looks fresh, actually.
Okay.
And what's Pete doing?
I'm walking along the edge of this porch, looking at the walls and trying to inspect it and see if I see anything odd or.
Aside from it floating.
Right, but.
The only other thing that you notice is the book in his lap.
Yeah, I want to take a look at that.
I'll try and take the book from him.
Oh, come on. I want to look over his shoulder and see what it says.
I want to take the book.
Jancine, are you taking the book?
I'm going to see if I can gently take it away from him to see if I can see anything, what it is.
Are you saying anything to him, or are you just taking it?
I'll ask him what's in the book.
What's in the book?
He doesn't say a word to you.
I'll ask him if I can. Can I look at the book?
Anybody looked in the barrel?
No response.
I'll look in the barrel.
I try and take the book from him.
Okay, he lets you have it.
What do you see, okay. Jan?
What do I see?
It's a book of poems. Every poem is a short rhyme similar to the confused verses he spouted earlier. The first page contains an inscription. To Luke, my beloved brother, Marcel.
Okay.
Do they look like riddles, maybe? I'm asking.
Do they have any rooms around them, or?
No rooms.
So what's in the barrel? I look in the barrel.
There are apples, tomatoes, and wheat.
I eat an apple. Yeah.
And there's some beef jerky.
And I pocket the jerky.
Okay.
Pocket the jerky. Eat an apple. All right.
Okay. That's pretty much it. I mean, that's... You've gotten everything out of the shack. The guy is not saying a word. He's not doing anything around you. He seems just sort of... lost.
This is a
could I zombified a little bit.
Go ahead.
So,
is that poem in the book that he said?
Yes.
Does anyone know what language it is?
It's not.
Anybody try poking him?
What's that?
Don't poke him.
Pass well, the phone. If
this with a finger,
we could read it. So obviously, it's in a language we can understand, or.
Common. Sure. I'm checking it out here. There's also fresh drinking water in that barrel.
I'll drink some water.
Y'all are very happy to see that.
I fill up my water thing. The water thing.
I'm drinking the wine, eating food.
I'm watching everybody else do that. Hey, and observing their behavior.
Bannon, can I get some of that wine?
Sure, buddy. Here you go.
So, while you guys are trying to figure out like what's going on in here, every once in a while he spouts off about verses from that book. But that's all he says.
Hmm.
There's nothing else in there. Ain't no kind of furniture, no kind of rug, nothing.
No.
So I think this guy's just lost it. You know, he lives in a floating house. But, you know, clearly somebody gives him food. But I think he's lost it. I think we should get out of here before whoever's feeding this dude shows up and realize we're going to steal all his stuff.
So that's the question. Should we steal all his stuff? Or?
We'd steal all his stuff. This guy's, you know, clearly out of it.
This dude looks great.
I think we should leave some.
Honest, I'm going to check his pockets.
I'm going to leave his book. I don't want to take his book because it seems like it's a personal item.
I can't read, so.
I'm having a rough time with that one.
Okay.
Take some food, take some water. Take all the wine he has.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to care about you guys taking anything. But, I mean, y'all kind of racked up on food, you know, water. He doesn't seem to care.
Wine.
He doesn't seem to care that you took his book, either.
Yeah, against my better judgment, I grabbed the book before I leave.
Okay.
Say before he even
he makes no movements to stop you. And he continues to recite from it occasionally.
Hmm.
So it is getting near dark.
Okay. Why is he surrounded by lanterns? I don't get that. Is it to ward off the night?
Why don't you ask further on this? Yeah.
That's who?
Jan.
So why don't we look at the guy? So let's inspect the lanterns.
Yeah, what's with the lanterns? I'll ask him why does he have so many lanterns around. Is he trying to ward off something?
It doesn't say a word back.
I take a lantern.
Okay. What do you do with it?
I'm just going to take it because it's light and it's getting dark.
Hold on.
Wouldn't you agree?
Are they just regular lanterns or are there anything inscribed on them?
No, there's nothing inscribed.
Do they seem to give off any, like...
light?
No. Energy? Light. Any type of mystical energy? Like, use insight to see if there's anything peculiar about the lantern?
Nothing peculiar.
I'm kind of sleepy.
He doesn't seem bothered by... He's a little agitated that you moved the lamp.
Maybe we should just stay in this cabin.
Put the lantern back. It
doesn't seem big enough for that, but
no, you can all you can fit. Yeah.
Okay.
Seems safer than the ground.
The ground isn't even ground. It's waist deep water.
Yeah. Which for me is neck deep.
I mean, at this point, is it dark? Is it nighttime?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, anything that keeps my feet out of the water for right now.
I'll go out and pull up that rope bridge, or that rope ladder.
Yeah, I put the lantern back.
Maybe we should blow out the lantern?
I don't know. I'm not sleeping with the lights off, because this guy might disappear on us. I'm not about that happening again.
I'm going to reaffirm this for you guys. The person that picked up the book from him, whoever it was. Who was it?
That was me.
I picked it up first. Yeah. And then.
Who's the first person?
After leaving, I actually took it, like I said, against my better judgment. But I was.
Who picked it up and read it?
I did.
That was Jan.
Jan, yeah.
Okay. It's a collection of children's poems. Each poem is a short rhyme similar to the confused verses that he's been uttering occasionally. The first page contains an inscription, "To Luke, my beloved brother," signed Marcel.
Oh. I don't know who Marcel is, but...
Yeah.
Do you want to try maybe addressing him?
Hey, Luke.
Who's addressing him?
I was suggesting Jan did, but Merla, I think, jumped in.
Well, I would. Merla asked Luke who if he knows who his father is.
He stares blankly into space.
He didn't say no. He didn't say nothing. No.
Hey, Luke, it's me, Marcel.
It's impossible. I'll never join you.
He said that Superman 2 is his favorite film of all time.
He said Superman 2? Wow. Well, I'm going to throw him out in the swamp.
All right, y'all know it's 3.
Oh, it was 4.
4.
Are we staying in this house overnight?
I think we should.
So,
yeah.
First of all...
As long as we keep good watch.
Yeah, Stella...
He's a weirdo, but he seems to pose no danger.
Stella and Merla are not taking the first watch.
Yeah, they passed out instantly last time.
This is the gypsies. I'm telling you, they got crazy magic.
I say we go one at a time, 1 hour watches.
Yeah.
Me and Thanon will take the first watch. We'll stay awake.
Although he doesn't seem to pose a threat, I don't feel good about us all just passing out with this weirdo.
Okay.
With us.
All
right. I only need 4 hours of rest, so me and Thanon will take it. And then he can sleep.
You guys go on to bed.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you'll pick your spells for next time.
Okay.
I believe that's it.